Hi guys, I'm making this video to just discuss in very very short about the angles which are used in CTV, right? The angles used in CTV. You know that with the recent change in the examination pattern for the NEET going towards the next, and as well as the change of pattern of question in the AIIMS examination, now they ask you several different types of questions. And with this new INICET, you know that the AIIMS is going to conduct the exam for admission into other brand universities as well, like JIPMER or PGI, NIMHANS, like that. Okay, so one of the question which can be commonly asked to you is that match the side A with side B, or which of the column or which of the section given, option A, B, C, D given, is wrong, right? So to match the angle, so we should know the angles used in CTV as well as why these angles are made and what is the significance of these angle. So first of all, coming on to CTV, you know that the club foot, what exactly, how does it looks like? So in which the foot automatically becomes like this, right? So once we are aware of the deformities of the foot, then it is easy for us to remember the angles also. Okay, so now you see there are four common deformities which are a part of CTV. What are those common deformities? The common deformities are, number one is cavus. What exactly is cavus? Cavus means, you all can see that. Now cavus is simply when the arch, this arch is increased. When the arch is increased, and why the arch is increased, where is the arch increasing basically? You all can appreciate this. Observe this image. Can you observe this? This break in the foot. So when we divide the foot typically can be divided into three parts. The hind foot, if I just draw, this is the hind foot, right? This is the midfoot, and this all is the forefoot. So you can see that the break is basically occurring here. This. So why this is occurring? Because the great toe, the thumb of the foot basically, it bends down, it goes into plantar flexion. So when it goes into plantar flexion, this thumb, it goes into plantar flexion, it causes increase in the arch, like you can appreciate over here, a better appreciation over here. This is what you call a cavus. Okay, so first deformity is cavus. Second deformity associated with CTV, it is adduction. Where does adduction occurs? Where does adduction is seen? Now you appreciate here in this image, the CTV image, this is the hind foot, this is the forefoot, and see this, the midfoot, sorry, and this forefoot. So see the forefoot basically, this deviation of the forefoot is what you call adduction. So adduction deformity is seen at forefoot, and the primary joint involved for this adduction deformity, it is a talonavicular joint. Although the joint involved is talonavicular, but this is seen around the forefoot. The forefoot deviating, see this, the forefoot deviating more medially as compared to the midfoot and hindfoot. So you know that the hindfoot, midfoot, and forefoot. And in adduction, what is happening? Hindfoot, midfoot, and the forefoot is deviating like this, medially. So it is going like this. So you all can see. So this deformity, the first one, is cavus. This break in the foot because of the plantar flexion of the great toe is cavus. Then the break here in the forefoot here is adduction. The third one, deformity, it is varus. Varus means what? Where does varus occurs? Varus basically occurs with calcaneum. If you consider my right ankle area, you know that my right calcaneum, which is the heel bone, it is facing laterally like this, and my talus would be facing medially like this. Okay, so they make an angle like this with each other. So calcaneum faces laterally and talus faces medially. So when this calcaneum, see this, when this calcaneum, it starts deviating medially or laterally, then we call it varus or valgus. So here in this image, you can see that the deviation of the callus is occurring towards the great toe, that is medially. So this is what you call varus. So when the calcaneum deviates, instead of like this, now the calcaneum deviates like this. This is what you call the varus, the hind foot moving towards medial side, right? It's a part of the limb distal to the joint moving medial side. And then there is equinus. What is that equinus? Equinus means when the ankle is bending down. When the ankle is bending down, ankle means what? The tibia and the talus. The tibia and the talus, that is tibiotalar joint. So equinus is tibiotalar joint. Okay, so these are primary deformities. Okay, now all of these when combined, they make the foot go into inversion. When all of these combine, they make the foot go into inversion. Inversion means that the under surface of the foot can be seen on the medial side. If the foot was like this, now you can see my foot like this. That is inversion. Under surface of the foot can be seen on medial side, right? So this basically, this inversion, it is primarily involving the telo calcaneal joint. Right? So who is the culprit bone here? Who is the culprit bone? The talus. Talus is the culprit bone here. Okay, so now coming on to the angles basically. So all of these four deformities, primary four deformities, can be seen with the help of angles also. How? Let's see them one by one. Okay, so first of all, let's take the AP view and the lateral view to assess which angle. The first angle we are going to take is between the talus and the calcaneum. That is telocalcaneal angle. That is telocalcaneal angle. And this angle is also known as the Kite's angle. Who was Kite? The first fellow who started treating the CTVs with some other method though. Right now, the method we are using to treat the CTV patients or the children, it is Ponseti technique. It is Ponseti technique. Right? Now, see this. If you see the X-ray of this child, this one is an AP view. You all can observe. So in AP view, the Kite's angle, the tibiotalus and the calcaneal angle, it is somewhere between 25 to 55 degrees, approximately. And approximately in the lateral view, the same angle is somewhere between 30 degrees to 55 degrees. There is an approximate angle. Okay? This is normal angle I'm telling you. The normal angle I'm telling you, it is in the normal foot. Now what happens in CTV? I told you already that this calcaneum and talus, which are making an angle of 25 to 35 degrees, the calcaneum deviates medially, producing what? Varus. So when they move, the calcaneum moves medially and then it goes down, the plantar flexed. So what is happening? Basically, the long axis of talus and calcaneum right now is like this cross. And when the calcaneum deviates medially, the long axis of both the bones will be parallel to each other. So how much will be the angle? Almost zero or negative. That is what you see here. Here, this bone that you see, the bone that you see over here, it is a talus, right? The calcaneum and the cuboid in front of that. So there are basically two bones. If I mark, this one is calcaneum. I'll use another color for talus. This one is cuboid, the calcaneum and the cuboid. And where is the talus? The talus is here. This one is a talus. This one is talus. So now you see a line through the talus and a line through the calcaneum. Is it 25 to 55? No, it is decreased. So what happens in CTV? In CTV, this angle is decreased. So in CTV, if in AP view or lateral view, the telocalcaneal angle is decreased, it is suggestive of what deformity? It is suggestive of the varus deformity, which is produced due to medial deviation of the calcaneum. Right? So this is telocalcaneal angle, the angle number one. Number two, let's come on to this. Number two is, now again, if I label, this is your talus bone in the red and in the blue is your calcaneum here, and this one is the calcaneo cuboid area. Okay, now second angle is, now we check for the I'll come on to cavus also. So first we have taken only the varus. Now we take an angle between the talus. Second angle we take between the talus and the first metatarsal. Second angle we take between the talus and the first metatarsal. So if I just, you know, take a scale, if I put a line through the first, through the normal foot, so a normal line through the talus, and you see here the line through the first metatarsal, somewhat like this almost. So they make an angle. They make an angle. This normal angle, the talus and the first metatarsal normal angle, is somewhere between 5 degrees to 15 degrees approximately. This is a normal angle. In CTV, this is a normal foot. This is a normal foot. Now what happens in CTV? What happens in CTV? You can see that in CTV, if I again label the talus, this one is a talus. This one is a talus. And then first metatarsal over here. So now you see what has happened. The forefoot, I told you, the forefoot deviates medially, producing what? Adduction. So this talus, and this was the line of the first metatarsal. So first metatarsal crosses the line of the axis of the talus. So it is going towards almost in the negative direction, right? So almost a decrease, basically a decrease in negative side. A decrease in negative side, you can say, because the forefoot is slightly, if you see your own foot, the forefoot is slightly laterally outwards like this. It is deviated. So decrease towards the negative side, it is suggestive of what? Adduction. It is suggestive of adduction. So here you can see the angle shown is 86 degrees. They have taken a normal angle, that how much is it? But as compared to this one, it is going into negative direction. So it was 5 to 15, it will decrease, right? So angle here, it has changed. So this is suggestive of adduction. Coming on to the third one, the equinus. Coming on to the third one, how does equinus occurs? So equinus, how it is calculated? It is calculated by measuring an angle between tibia and the calcaneum. Now, I was asked a question that, why not talus? Because the culprit is talus, it's not the calcaneum. So basically you have to understand, we take one line, how we take, measure this equinus angle, one line through the tibia, okay? And second line through the calcaneum like this, right? Why calcaneum and why not talus? It is simply because other than talus, below the talus you have got calcaneum. So when the talus moves down in the plantar flexion direction, it will move calcaneum also. So only the movement of talus is not going to tell you the actual equinus you have. Actual equinus will be the last bone of the limb, that will be calcaneum. So the normal angle of equinus that we have between the tibia and the calcaneum, it is somewhere around 10 to 40 degrees. In CTEV, when the calcaneum starts deviating down, it starts increasing. So increase in angle is suggestive of what deformity? We have discussed that, it is equinus. Okay, moving on to the last angle we have. The last angle we have is about the cavus. So we talked about adduction, varus, and the this equinus, and now it is about the cavus. So I told you that cavus is because of increase in the arch of the foot, which occurs due to the first metatarsal bending down. So if I take a shadow over here, if I take a shadow of the here, from here, this one, this is the line of talus. This is the line of talus, okay? And second line is the line of this metatarsal. See, these are two lines I have drawn. I have taken one metatarsal here. Okay, let me take that again. So this one, the first metatarsal. So I draw a line through the first metatarsal, and then I draw a line through the talus. So when I draw these two lines, what I see, the intersection over here, if you are able to see that or no. Okay, so talus and the first metatarsal, this angle is normally, cavus is seen by the angle of talus and first metatarsal. Okay, that is in lateral view, right? So talus first metatarsal AP view is seen for adduction deformity. Talus first metatarsal lateral view is seen for cavus deformity. So normal angle is 0 degrees to 4 degrees, right? So when it increases more than 4 degrees, it is known as cavus deformity. So when the first metatarsal will bend down, obviously it will be like this. So angle will be increasing. If angle is less than 0 degree, we call it pes planus, that is flat foot, right? You might have heard that entity, the flat foot. So pes planus, so when it is more than 4 degrees, cavus. When the angle is less than 0 degrees or going towards negative, pes planus, right? So I hope this will help you out to understand, have a broad imagination how the angles will be changing with the formation of CTV in the foot, right? So CAVE, Ponseti technique, the sequence of correction and the angles. So this video is not about the complete CTV, it is only about the angles of CTV, okay? So I hope this video helps you out. So do let me know the reviews about this particular video, and definitely I am making more on the topics that you have informed me, okay? So enjoy orthopedics. Thank you so much, and see you again with a new video very, very soon.